One of the ways you're most likely to encounter JSON data is through the use of a web service. A web service is essentially a database that you can access using HTTP requests. With a web service, you formulate queries as URLs. So I'd like to take a look at a simple example using the musicbrains.org site. The nice thing about this site is that we don't need an API key, so it will be very easy for you to experiment with the code I'm going to give you. Okay, MusicBrainz is essentially a wiki, but one that provides a web service with access to their data. The type of data MusicBrainz maintains is metadata on music. So we can ask questions about artists, labels, recordings, etc. Now the way that we query this site is by constructing a URL that has musicbrainz.org as a base, but then specifies a particular entity, the type of data we're interested in getting back, and we can specify some additional parameters that allow us to be specific about exactly what features or what metadata we'd like to get back for a given entity, so say for an artist. Now, one thing that we're going to have to do in order to use this site is if we want to get specific information about an artist, we actually need to know its unique identifier, that is the MusicBrainz unique identifier. And this theme of unique identifiers is something that's going to come up over and over and over again in this course in a variety of different ways. So the first thing that we're going to do is actually use their search interface, and we're just going to pass in a query that includes a search term for the artist we're interested in finding information about. We're going to process the results that come back from that query in order to get the ID for that particular artist, and then we can request information about a specific artist using that ID. Now, lest you think I'm a one-trick pony, we're actually going to ask for data for a different artist, in this case, Lucero. So here's where we're doing our first query. And this is going to give us back a result set. Now we're going to process that result set in order to get back the ID for Lucero, the MusicBrainz ID for Lucero. Now, I'm not going to go into this in too much detail, but something I want to point out here is that what's happening is when we issue this query, the response we get back is JSON data. Using the JSON module in Python, we can read in that data and it will simply be translated into the appropriate Python objects. Now, a JSON object is equivalent to a Python dictionary. So what we're accessing right here is that Python dictionary, and we're going to access the artist's field of that dictionary. That field happens to have an array as its value, and I happen to know that the second object in that array is the one I'm actually interested in, the band Lucero from Memphis. Okay. Now, we want the ID for this particular artist. The value of an artist is another object. It was a JSON object, and the results we got back from MusicBrainz, in our case, because we're working in Python, the JSON module has translated it into another Python dictionary. So the ID field contains the value we're actually interested in getting here. Okay, then what we're going to do is query the site again, this time specifically requesting information on this particular ID, the ID that we got back from our first query. Well, I should say from processing our first query. All right, so then we're going to issue this second query. We're actually going to ask for releases, and you can look above in the code here to see what's going on here. Essentially, what I've done is implemented some convenience code that allows us to easily pass in the parameters that MusicBrainz is expecting in order to get the releases data back. Okay, and then the rest of this is simply printing out the results. So let's take a look at what the results look like. So here's the result of having dived into the results set from that first query to get the artist we're interested in. Okay, here's the ID we care about. And then if we look down, a couple of things I want to point out here. I've set up this code so that each time it makes a request out to this web service, it prints out the URL. All right, again, remember that URL is how we specify our query to a web service. So musicbrainz.org, I'm specifying that I want to access the web service, version 2 of the web service. I believe at least that's what this 2 means. And then I'm saying the entity I'm interested in is artist, and here's the ID for that artist. Now, what I want you to do is give me back data that's formatted as JSON, and this particular parameter for MusicBrainz is where we specify exactly what metadata we'd like to receive in response. It's kind of a catch-all for everything. If we want more than one type of metadata, we simply concatenate them together here. In this case, I'm just interested in releases, okay? So then what I did in the code was I actually processed the response that I got back to this query to pull out the very first release, okay? And here is the object in Python. It's going to be a dictionary that represents or that stores the data for that first release. This happens to be a release entitled 2012 420 Webster Hall, New York. As it turns out, I was actually at this show. My wife had surprised me by flying in my best friend, who's also a big Lucero fan. Okay, so then what I did was, in here, I used a list comprehension to process all of the releases and extract just the title for each one of those releases. And then I'm simply printing them all out here. So what I encourage you to do with this code is take a look at all of it, get a sense for how it works, and then experiment on your own with some queries. You can look for different artists. You can use some of the conveniences that we've provided here to query for different types of metadata about a given artist. Okay? So just play with this part of the code or work with Python in the Python interpreter and just get a sense for the data that's here. What I really encourage you to do is print out the full results set. Dive into exactly what type of data is coming back. It's all just hierarchical data structure that has objects or arrays nested within other objects or arrays. Following this, we'll have a quiz where we actually ask you to answer some specific questions. So you will have to be able to query this web service correctly.